Get ready to match the stars. Larry Hovis. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. Patti Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Madlyn Rhue. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
How do you do, my dear? How are you?
Oh, just fine, thank you. Yourself?
I'm very well, thank you for inquiring.
I'm going straight to the wake after the show?
Yes, I'm going right to the wake.
Oh, I think
yes.
You look pretty.
I thought
do you think I look pretty?
You were going to
you
a wedding.
Come up and give me a kiss there. What's that?
I didn't know whether there'd been a death in the family or you were going to a wedding.
See how
get
nice
your hands
I look?
Up that fat lady.
before you, have you had any of the diseases on this list?
No, I haven't.
It's my pleasure.
What do you say we say hello to our current champ? You want to do that?
Sure. Hi, here's current champ.
Hello, current
Hi,
champ.
Stars.
Arlene Bissot.
Bissot.
Yeah. Well, that's the third time I get it to you. Arlene has won $800, and she's feeling happy about that, and she's going to have a go at some really big money, $1,000, right?
Right.
Okay. We're ready for that. If you are, Arlene, we'll have a go at that right after this message. Don't we make a lovely couple?
That's the only one.
Are you ready? Okay. Arlene, you've been here before. You know how the super match goes.
We've done that.
No, we haven't done that. We did the first part of it, and she won $100. That means you are playing for 10 times that amount now, or $1,000. Now, to collect, remember, you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be an exact match, and you have to choose one now.
Larry.
Larry. Larry Hovis.
Hi, Gene.
There's Larry Hovis. He's the one. Okay. Larry, you get ready to write.
Okay.
Arlene, you face
me.
See
how calm he is? He's hysterical on the inside.
Fill in this blank, if you would, please, Larry. Blank. Mill. M-I-L-L. Blank mill. Okay, he's finished now. And Arlene, we need your response to this. Blank mill.
Paper.
Paper mill, she said. All right, Larry, for $1,000, may we see your answer?
Yes. I said old.
Old mill. I guess there's a lot of good ones there. Flour mill is good. Old mill. What's that?
Saw.
Sawmill is another good one. Okay.
Well, I couldn't read it.
Now, Arlene, you've got your $800 and you're the champ. You're going to meet another player and play another game. You ready for that?
Sure am.
All right, let's welcome Natalie Ricketts. Hello, Natalie. You ladies know each other, I take it?
Yes, we do.
We welcome you, Natalie, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would, please.
Well, I'm a retired school teacher, now married, and we have a beautiful little boy who's celebrating his fourth birthday this month.
Do you remember how you met your husband?
Right now, I'm having trouble remembering anything, but I think it was at a party.
At a party. Okay. Take a deep breath, Natalie. See how calm you are now? All right, good luck to Natalie and to Arlene. We'll ask Natalie the challenger to make a selection.
A, please.
A is what she wants. Here we go, folks. As the court jester sat in the dungeon, he said, "Well, I guess that's the last time I make any jokes about the king's blank." As he sat, the court jester said that while he was sitting in the dungeon. In the dungeon. Well, I guess that's the last time I make any jokes about the king's blank. All right. Charles has written 12 answers already. At least. Now he's got them. And we'll come to Natalie and ask her. Well, I guess that's the last time I make any jokes about the king's...
belly.
Belly. Oh, this is fat King Charles. Was King Charles fat, was he?
Henry
no,
VIII
Louis was
a
fat,
little
yeah.
chunky around the middle.
Rotund. What did you say about this king?
Oh, I used an American Indian word for belly. I said nose.
Sorry, nice try, though, Larry. Brett?
Why did you ask that woman where she met her husband? Do you know something we don't?
No, I just thought she, you know, might be an interesting story there, that's all.
Oh, just natural curiosity?
Yeah, that's right.
I said mistress.
Okay, that's what you said.
Why did you say mistress?
Why did you say mistress? All right, Charlie.
Just interesting curiosity.
I said the king's mother.
You said the king's mother. So far, we've got nose, mistress, and mother.
Uh-huh.
What do you contribute?
I said the king's queen.
The king's queen?
Yes.
All right.
It can be read many different ways.
That's right. That's one reading there. Okay.
Yeah, I never thought of him. I thought of the king's wife. Although I knew
they were
very close.
Come on, Madlyn, go.
King's wife.
King's wife. So belly didn't happen there, Natalie. Sorry about that. Here we go with one for Arlene, folks. Claire said to Bill, will you please teach this dog not to blank me? Claire said to Bill, will you please teach this dog not to blank me?
Could I ask the gender of the dog?
No, you cannot.
What gender?
Yeah.
What gender was it? No, Brett asked me to ask.
I'm not going to tell.
Okay. Well, are you just genderless, that's all.
Probably, yes. You're going to be, would you like to be a go-go girl on Match Game 74?
I was a go-go girl. I was a gypsy, a dance with the Latin Quarter.
No kidding.
That's what they said when they hired me.
I'm the only straight man in the place. All right, here we go, Arlene. What was the question? Oh, yeah, will you please teach this dog not to blank me?
Lick me.
Lick me. Well, there are a lot of good choices there. Lick me, bite me, and all that. What'd you say?
I said bite.
You said bite. Yeah. Another good answer.
Now,
though lick is not bad. Don't be discouraged, Arlene. You may get one here. Brett?
Now you asked me for my answer. Now you're turning against me.
No, I'm not. Please, Brett, may we see your answer?
All right.
Sweet
lady. There are. I said kiss or lick. And so the... Well, kiss, I didn't bother to write it because it's so boring to have to...
No, that's a tongue.
Yeah.
But
yes.
You're going to match that. Kiss or lick. Okay. All right. Charles?
I just said bite.
Bite.
As Larry.
I'm
bite.
So tired of the hostility of this world.
I'm tired of the lick.
Go ahead.
I said wet me.
Wet me. All right. Richard?
I am surprised.
You shouldn't be. We've known one another.
I wrote wet meat.
All right, Miss Latin Quarter.
Right, lick me.
Oh. Lick me. Okay. So that's 2-0. And it's the end of round one, and we'll come back to do round two, but first we've got to do a little business here. This is it. All right, here we go with round two, ladies. There it is. 2-0 favor the champ. Natalie, please make a selection.
I'll try B this time.
B. All right, this is for you. As Milton nervously proposed marriage, Gladys calmly blanked her nose. As Milton nervously proposed marriage, Gladys calmly blanked her nose.
I think Larry went to private school. He prints so well.
Yes, he does. All right. Everybody's finished, Natalie. As Milton nervously proposed marriage, Gladys calmly blanked her nose.
Thunder nose.
Thunder nose? That was her way of saying,
I love you.
Larry, what did you say?
Oh, that, you know, that's
Gladys.
The Eskimo acceptance.
Oh, it is?
Oh, yeah. I said blue.
Blue. Got to have two to stay in the game. Watch it, Brett.
Well, I didn't think of anything else except blue.
Blue. That's two, Charles.
Well, since you can't green your nose, I too said blue.
Yeah. Right. Okay, Patti.
Another blowing of the nose.
Right. You got to match both remaining celebrities, Natalie, or it's all over, Richard.
You ask me, there's a lot of blue noses here.
That's right.
Unfortunately, I put white.
White. So Arlene wins once again. Congratulations. Sorry, Natalie. It's been a pleasure meeting you. We've got a gift for you backstage, together with our thanks for being with us in Match Game 74. Natalie Rickens. Goodbye, Natalie. Okay. Now, here we go again. A go at over 5,000. You ready?
Sure.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, Arlene, and we got their best response to this. Making blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, too, if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Which three celebrities would you like a little assist from here?
Brett. How about making out?
Your place or mine?
If you're going to argue about it, forget it.
Why aren't you clapping at my answer?
Because... Brett, would you let me run the show?
Hey. Oh, I'm sorry. Okay.
Making out is Brett's answer. Another celebrity.
Richard.
Making whoopee.
All right, another bride.
What? Madlyn.
Making up.
No.
All right, you got making out, making whoopee, and making up. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Making love.
Yay! Making love. It's the second offer I've had in the last 2 minutes. Okay, making love is the answer she's looking for. Let's find out if it is up here. First, the $100 response. Making money is up there, which is not on anybody's list there. Let's look for making love by revealing the $250 response. Making whoopee is up there. That was Richard's answer. All right, third and last chance, Arlene, for making love here. Here is the $500 response. Love it is! You got it! Good girl! Okay. Now you've got the $500, and you know you're playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Remember to collect, you got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Has to be an exactly little late with the dinger there. I said 5,000 a long time ago. Watch the way you handle your dinger. Okay. Now, you have to choose one celebrity now.
Madlyn.
Okay. Madlyn, you get ready to write. Arlene will face me. Here is the $5,000 question. Blank. Head. H-E-A-D. All right, Madlyn is ready. Now, Arlene, we need a response from you. Blank head.
Bald.
Bald head is her answer, Madlyn, for $5,000. May we see yours?
Indian
head. Okay, Arlene, you've got $1,400. You're still a champ. You're going to play another game. But first, we've got this message to pass along. All right. We're going to start another game. To do that, we've got to meet a new player. So let's welcome Sandy Zipser. Hi, Sandy. Sandy's going to tell us a little bit about herself, so let's all pay attention now. Sandy, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm a native-born Californian, and I'm married to an attorney. I have a 3.5-year-old daughter, and I have 4 kitty cats.
4 kitty cats? Really? I guess
she's 4 teeth out.
4 teeth.
No, 4 kitty cats.
Oh,
she's a cat lover. All right, good luck to both ladies. And Sandy, you know how to play the game. You know that when I push this button, it'll reveal 2 questions. And we ask you, the challenger, to make a selection.
I'll pick A.
A is for Sandy. We ask you to make the selection because some contestants find some questions harder than others. We try and make them all of equal difficulty. Here it is. Raquel said, after Dr. Welby removed my appendix, he blanked it. Blanked it. Raquel said that. After Dr. Welby removed my appendix, he blanked it. It's kind of a wild, wide-open question, isn't it?
Certainly is.
All right. All ready? Okay, they're all set. So, Sandy, After Dr. Welby removed by appendix, he...
pickled it.
He pickled it. I think that's a good answer. I mean, it was a historic moment, and he saved that appendix. Larry?
He pickled it?
Well, you know, he put it in formaldehyde to preserve it, is what he did. That's what you meant by that. Isn't that what you meant by that? All right.
That's ghoulish. He stuffed it.
He stuffed it. Oh. Brett?
Would anybody like to see my gallbladder operation? I had a terrific doctor. It's a marvelous short love. Well, never mind. Maybe later.
16 millimeter?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Pickled.
There's a match for you, Sandy.
Charles.
His office needed a lot of decoration, so he framed it.
Very good.
Throw that away.
Patti? No, that's a good answer. Patti?
I was in his office, and he did frame it.
He did frame that appendix,
yeah.
In 3D.
It's by the door and the umbrella stand. It's so lovely.
And the glitter was
lovely. It's lovely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Charles. Richard. Hello, Richard.
Please call me Charles. I'd like him to be blamed for this. No, he did pickle it. He bottled it.
That's bottled and pickled? That's... No? Oh, really?
Just a second.
Are you sure about that?
Well, hold it, Joe. Is there a doctor in the house?
Well, you know, if he could...
I didn't know what they called
it. There it
really?
Is. Yeah.
I just didn't know the word. Bottled it.
That's right. You know, these English, they talk funny,
well,
so...
Well, I mean, he wasn't going to sell it to a liquor company.
All right. What did you say, Madlyn?
Well, actually, my darling, since I've become English, he bottled it.
He did bottle it.
Oh.
So there it is. All right.
Would you unhook yourself, please?
Yeah, I'm unhooked now. All right. Arlene, are you ready? Well, I'm not. Okay, this is for Arlene. Everybody plays. Here we go. After catching the beautiful mermaid, George took her home to blank. After catching the beautiful mermaid, George took her home to blank. Can you see through all that hair?
It doesn't matter.
Oh.
Oh. Oh.
Ready. Oh, Charles. Bravo, Charles.
Grazie.
You're working very hard again. What are you up to these days?
Me? Oh, yeah. Not much. Just game shows.
No.
Employment office.
I'm going to do a serious role in a medical center. I don't know if this is this network. I don't know
what it is. I don't care. If you want to plug it, plug
it. Yes, medical center.
Good. Everybody ready? So, stop the music and listen to Arlene's answer. After catching the beautiful mermaid, George took her home to...
Mother.
To mother. Took her home to mother.
How do you know his mother wanted one?
Hell, I don't know. What did you say, Larry?
I said his waterbed.
Okay, Larry. I think you've caught on to the game.
Great.
Brett?
He's slow, but when he finally gets there, it's not bad, is it?
Terrific.
What?
What? No,
go ahead.
We don't
want to hear about that. His aquarium.
His aquarium. Okay, you get the buzzer on that, Charles.
He took her home to swim.
To swim.
And after that, it's up for grabs.
Yeah. What'd you say, Patti?
I said that he took her home to mother.
Sure.
Oh,
so, there's one for you. What did you say?
Heads or tails. Took her home to mama.
Mother.
Oh, one more.
Madlyn, are you ready?
Yes, I had mother didn't like it, so I said to marry her.
Took her home to marry her.
Yeah.
Mother didn't like him, but I see.
Mother, no.
Okay, now it's 3-2 in favor of Sandy, and it's the end of round one, and we've got to stop for a moment and do this, and we'll come back and talk to you. Come back. Got to stop right here because we've run out of time, ladies, but we'll look forward to seeing you both next time. 3-2 the score. We'll do round two when we meet again, okay? All right. Now, I want to thank each and every one of you personally for your contribution here.
Thank you.
I thank you personally, Larry.
Thank you, Gene.
You were splendid.
Had a lot of fun.
You're beautiful as always, Brett. Aww. Brett cracks me up all the time, especially when she says, I'm so nervous I may give my right age.
How old are you?
Charles, you were splendid as always. We'll look forward to seeing you in a serious role. Really?
Yes, you know what I'm playing? Seriously, a medical center, I'm playing a deaf mute. But you know something, why I have an edge on the part? I'm going to write a lot.
Oh, yeah, oh, yes.
Interesting.
We're training
that
you here.
That didn't go over, so move right on.
Nice to have you back, Patti.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah. And here's our mainstay. We really couldn't do it without old Richard. And Madlyn, you are a welcome fresh addition.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, when we all meet again next time, we're going to have this group of celebrities.
Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Maury Amsterdam, Juliet Mills, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a Westflox direct reading digital dial light alarm clock, wood grain finish, lighted dial, backed by years of experience, Westflox Italy Industries Company, and a supply of Griffin shoe polish, the polish that helps give shoes a long-lasting quality shine, Griffin paste, liquid, and all-white, and a supply of Swiss Miss Instant Cocoa Mix made with real miniature marshmallows and good non-fat dry milk already in it. You just add water. This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations.